glorious name. I have a word for someone here this morning. You shall break forth on every side. You shall break forth to the left, to the right, in the name of Jesus. God of heaven will make you to break forth on every side. In the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Please put your hands together for Jesus, and you may be seated in the presence of the Lord. This is our advancement hour, and this morning I want to be sharing briefly with us what I call the law of focus. The law of focus. Matthew chapter 6 and verse 22. Matthew 6, 22. I read, the light of the body is the eye. If therefore thy eye be single, thy whole body shall be full of light. I often like to read this scripture this way. The progress of the business, the career, the work of your hand is your vision. And if your vision be focused, single there means focus. Thy whole body, which is your whole business, your whole career, shall be full of progress or advancement. The progress of your life is in your vision. But vision without focus will lead to frustration. It is when vision is focused that the whole body shall be full of light, full of progress. So I can therefore say that progress in life, advancement in life, is focus limited. Until a man is focused, progress is not in view. I want you to paint a picture in your mind. Imagine someone running 100 meters dash. And the same person is not concentrating. He's looking up and down, looking for who is greeting him or who is abusing him. When will the person reach the tape? Before he will turn two times, other people have reached there. He will need utmost concentration. Most of the time you see them looking straight to the tape. Focus. If you are focused, you move in the right direction. When you are not focused, you divided attention. I discovered in life that distraction is a killer of destiny. No woman can accomplish much when he or she is distracted. Pursuing many things at the same time will actually leave you with nothing. Many of you are town people, you may not understand this. But in the village, when you go to chase rabbits, sometimes you need to put fire on the hole. And the rabbit, normally, there will not be one inside. Sometimes two, three. They will jump out from another hole. If they jump out, if you want to catch anyone, just follow one. If you want to catch the three or two at the same time, forget it. You have missed it. They will play with you. And that is how life is. Be a man, a woman of one thing per time. And that way, you'll be able to accomplish things. You can trace what you have seen and accomplish. There's an old saying, Jack of all trade, master of none. Jesus, the greatest leader, the greatest personality that ever lived on the earth here, when he came here, he was of one purpose. 1 John 3:8, he said, for this purpose, not purposes, this purpose, the Son of God came to make manifest that he may destroy the works of the devil. That's why he told them, I must be about my Father's business. This is why I came. A time came in John chapter 6 verse 15, he fed them with, he fed the multitude with bread and fish. They said, this man, what do we do? They gathered, they said, they wanted to make him king by force. John 6 15, Jesus escaped. Because that would be a distraction from his purpose. Please, I counsel each and every one of us, give quality attention to your assignment. Give quality attention to your business. Give quality attention to your career. Give quality attention to the work of your hand. You have one shop, pay attention to that shop. Don't be here and there. Whatever God has called you to do, the Bible says, let every man abide in his own calling. Pay attention to that assignment. Pay attention to that which is committed into your hand. There was a story in 1 Kings chapter 20, 39 and 40. 1 Kings 20, 39 and 40. A man was told, I was given an assignment to watch over a captive. But he was here and there. And the man escaped. And they said, you will pay with your life. When you are not focused, you are actually wasting your life. And most times, it may end in regret. But that will never be a portion in Jesus' name. 1 Kings 20, 39 and 40. He said, and as the king passed by, he cried unto the king and he said, thy servant went out into the midst of the battle, and behold, a man turned aside and brought a man unto me and said, keep this man. What was the assignment? Keep this man. If by any means he be missing, then shall thy life be for his life, or else thou shalt pay a talent of silver. And that thy servant was busy. Look at the busy there. B-U-S-Y. There is difference between busyness, B-U-S-I-N-E-S-S, and busyness, B-U-S-Y-N-E-S-S. Many people are busy. They are not in business. Moving around. Everywhere, but accomplishing nothing. But as thy servant was busy here and there, he was gone. And the king of Israel said unto him, so shall thy judgment be, thyself has decided it. Concentrate on your assignment. Please mind side distractions. Many things will want to seek your attention in life. Concentrate on your assignment, on the purpose, on what God has committed into your hand, on what you are doing. But time. What is focus? The Encounter Dictionary of English Language defined focus as concentrated effort or attention in a particular thing. Concentrated effort or attention in a particular thing. Many of us, you have snapped pictures before, and today you even do, even with your camera, you can snap. Now, when you want to get a good image, what do? You focus the lens, two of us. If you just go, okay, I want to snap, and this you are looking at, you just snap. When you see the picture, you won't like it. The same way, you may not like the result you get when you are not concentrated. You won't like it. But when you concentrate, you can say, this is what I'm saying. This is the result. You can like it. There's a little exercise or experiment we used to do in physics. When you carry a lens and you position it to the sun at a particular angle, and then you focus it on a paper, it can burn that paper. Sunlight, when it's focused through the lens, can burn that paper. Do you understand what I'm talking about? That's impact. But this sun, as you see it, even with the heat, it can't burn ordinary paper. But when it's focused through a lens, it can. That shows you the power of focus. You want to know the truth? Great things are not accomplished by you scattering yourself. I want you to live here with the determination to be a man or a woman of focus. One thing I've learned from God's servant, Bishop David Oyedepo, that has endeared me so much to him, is a man of one thing per time. Anything he wants to do, every other thing is geared towards it until that purpose is realized. If he's so winning now, you won't hear any other thing. Even in the teachings we do, you see, focus. This month, focus on this. Focus on this. Focus on this. Why? Some people will be, but is it not what said last Sunday? Is it not what we heard? Is it not? No. The more people hear the same thing, focus, they cannot grasp it. Not general knowledge, now they have a grasp of it. Are you getting what I'm talking about? So the same way, if you go back to your business, to your career, to the work of your hand, and that thing you are doing, if you're a carpenter, let them know you as a carpenter. Concentrate until they know you. People will only know you with your work, and they will know you with one thing. They won't know you with many things. Check every man of value today on the earth. Whether believer or unbeliever, when they call them, you know them with one thing. You know them with one thing. If you call Bishop Oyedepo now, it's the gospel. If you see it's somebody like Bill Gates now, talking about computer and all that, they will know you with something. What would they know you with? Now, please understand. Until you are focused, you may not be able to get required results. And if you don't have results, insult will come. Result is the answer to insult. Doesn't matter how many people are mocking you, just keep getting results. Very soon they will shut their mouth. And someone said, and I believe, when someone lacks the result, he will become a locust. What are the effects of this focus? Effects of focus. Number one is conserved energy or preserved strength. When you are a man or a woman of focus, you discover you are not spending your strength and your energy in things that don't matter to your goal. But if you are not, you'll be dispensing energy here and there. Your strength is being going different places, and that way you'll not be able to accomplish much. When you hear the word division, it simply talks about two focuses, just two visions. You are here, you are there, so you begin to dispense energy, and when you do that, you will not be able to accomplish much. Number two effect of focus is passion. You will never develop a passion for anything except you are focused on it. Focus helps you to develop passion. And you will never succeed in anything you are not passionate about. Passion will help you accomplish in a day what you may not be able to accomplish in a year without passion. I think my smooth doctor said that. One day of passion can bring you a result that 1 year without passion cannot bring you. And passion is a function of focus. When you are focused, paying attention on a particular thing. Don't you see, even revelation, you can't get revelation anyhow. But when you try it, when you focus on a scripture, sometimes, many hours, one scripture, you discover you begin to see certain things that are not, even when somebody has said, you mean this thing is in this scripture? Focus.
passion to drive you
in that business you are doing.
You need passion to drive you in that your career, but you will never develop it except you are focused on it.
Think about this issue. There are 50 prophets, 50 sons of the prophets who were following Elijah. 51, sorry. Elisha was one of them. At the end of the day, it was Elisha that amounted to something. Why? Focus. The other ones were distracted. You know, there were a lot of tests for Elisha. Even Elijah told him, at Giga, stay here. I'm going to Bethel. He said, I will go with you. Stay in Bethel. He said, no, I'm going to Jericho. He said, I will go with you. Even at Jericho, he said, I will go with you. Then when they crossed Jordan, it was after they crossed Jordan. Even when they crossed the Jordan, they were still focused. If you see me when I'm caught up. And the man, I believe, even when flies pass, he said, no, it no go distract me. I must see this. And he got it. My prayer for you from today is that you shall be a man, a woman of focus. That you not be distracted here and there. A lot of things want to call for your attention. But I see God helping each and every one of us will not be distracted in Jesus' name. Number three, effect of focus is impact. Impact is a function of focus. If you start dropping water from this roof now to a particular spot here, and the water is dropping, boom, 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 boom. After a short time, you discover it will make a hole there, three of us. Go and carry a tanker of water and pour here. At the same time, I see whether it will make a hole. It won't make any, it will only sweep the sand and push it to one side. Are you getting what I'm talking about? When you want to break a wall, if you are hitting it everywhere, hit here, you go and hit there, it may take you a longer time. But when it's concentrated, focus on a particular spot. And this is the same thing even boxers do. When they are boxing, they look at the man's weak point and they want to concentrate there. That's the only place they are looking for. Even in football, the same thing they do. When the coach knows that the man playing number three is weak, you will see they will just be moving towards that side. They want to penetrate through there. Do you understand? Impact is a function of focus. You can't make impact in that business if you are not focused. You can't make impact in that career, in that work of your hand, except you are focused. And today they say, it is Gary that is selling. And you want to move to go and sell Gary. You may not know some things about it. Before you know it, they say, today is granite. And you're moving like that. You just be here and there. If it's granite, concentrate on granite. And then before you know it, you'll be able to develop and know the secrets there. It is when you now have it, you begin to see you are making exploits that place. You are succeeding. Are you getting what I'm talking about? I'm not against investment. I'm not against diversifying to other areas. But be a man of one thing per time. Is somebody getting me now? Because somebody will be saying, won't I be here? Won't I do this? Yes, you can, but concentrate. When you have established and then God is leading you to another, why not? I hope you are understanding the context. I'm saying what I'm saying. But be a man. Don't carry many things at the same time. Just don't forget the story of that rabbit I told you. Pursuing many things at the same time, you will end up with nothing. But when you cannot make impact, you can have traceable, effective results to show. And you know, results have a way of encouraging you to pursue more. Hallelujah. May God give us understanding. In Jesus' mighty name. Number four is speed of progress. Speed. Speed. Many of us that drive, if you drive or if you have driven in the night, if your light, your headlamp is blurred, you know you will not move with speed. Three of us. But when it's sharp and concentrated, you can see well, then you can move with it. Speed. The same way, when you are a man of focus, you can gain speed, you can make better progress, you can make better advancement. Remember the scripture we read earlier? If your whole body, if you want your whole body to be full of light, to be full of progress, what do? You make your vision to be single, to be focused, and then you will be able to make progress and gain speed. I want to make this statement here that you can never be outstanding in anything you don't give full attention to. No matter your faith, no matter your discipline, no matter the, if you are not giving full attention to that, there's no how you can be outstanding. It's not possible. As a pastor, for instance, now if I like, now I can be jumping from here and they're going to, from Monday to, I've been scheduled members to be visiting their house one by one. Is it, visitation is good though. Amen. But see, if you are doing that, you may not be able to concentrate to feed them. Are you getting me now? And if you can't feed them, they will leave you. Concentrate. As I begin to close, what are the enemies of focus? Apart from distraction that we have earlier mentioned, I want you to pay attention to these things we're about to share now. Number one is wrong company, wrong association. If you are moving around with people who are not focused, you will naturally attract their habits. This is a fundamental law of life. He that walks with the wise shall be wise, but a companion of fools shall be destroyed. Proverbs 13:20. If you go to the airport or to the motor park, there are people you caught out. For instance, the airport, the man, he knows all the names of all the flights. He knows Eric is there, he knows Aero is there, he knows Chachange is there, he knows where they are going, but he has never traveled before. That's how it is in life. In that area of your business or your career, there are also touts. There are people like that. They may be, have signboard, but they're touts. They're not going anywhere. If you follow them, you just waste your life. Look for people who are focused, people who are going somewhere in that area, and those are people that you can relate with in that kind of line of business. And then that way, you'll be able to also to attract their own good habits, and then it will begin to work in your life. Number two, enemy of focus is wrong interest or even ambition. Wrong interest, wrong ambition. You know, ambition is simply what you want to accomplish by yourself. Vision is what God has told you to do. Now, if God has told you, you are sure it is God that called you into that business or into that career, because this is fundamental. We have discussed this last year. Now, it's important that you maintain such interest and not have wrong interest. If you have wrong interest, you discover it will distract you. It will do what? Distract you. Wrong interest will distract you from your main goal or your main vision or the main thing you are doing. It will distract you. And when you are distracted, you cannot be focused. You cannot be focused when you are distracted. And wrong interest, wrong ambition, we naturally distract you. Number three is ignorance. Ignorance. When you lack understanding of your purpose for living, there's no how you won't be distracted, because everything will seem good to you. That it seems right does not make it right. Is that not so? That something seems right to you does not make it right. So ignorance, I think this is one of the basic things that makes people not to be focused, because they don't even know what they're looking for. If you don't know where you're going, everything will look like it. If you don't know what you are here to accomplish, if you don't even know what you are looking for, what am I set to accomplish in this business? What am I looking for? Where am I supposed to be? If you don't know, everything will just go haywire. But my prayer is that by this kind of understanding we are receiving today, God will set us on the right path in Jesus' mighty name.
that none of us will miss our place in life in Jesus' name. None of us shall be distracted again in the name of Jesus. That as we begin to focus, we begin to get the results in quick succession in the name of Jesus. That you'll be moving from glory to glory in the name of Jesus. That you accomplish from one accomplishment to another accomplishment in the name of Jesus. So shall it be in Jesus' glorious name.